This part of the course tells you about formats and arrays. So we'll be learning more and more about the SAS language, and the topic here is formats. How can we make SAS data easier to understand? And arrays, how can we handle a list of variables at once? There are two example data sets that you can download from the home page, and the first one is called Hernior, and it contains of 32 patients who underwent an elective procedure. Some of these variables, ID number, age in years, are easy to work with, but some of the other variables, we actually, before we can use them, we have to know how are they coded. So there's a variable here with the variable name PSTAT, and that's the physical status, discounting that associated with the operation. So apart from the reason for the operation, how was the physical status of the patients? And we don't know how it's coded, so we can't do anything useful with it, but checking up with the people who supplied this data set, I find out that it is coded going from 1 to 5, and 1 is the best health status, the best physical status, and 5 is the worst. And in this data set, if you look at it, only the values 1, 2, and 3 occur. And so we might want to recode this, or at very least, even if we keep it in three levels, we certainly need to know what is good and what is bad. The same, of course, goes for the cardiac and RESP, so variables that code if you had preoperative complications. The condition upon leaving the operating room is, of course, a very important variable, and we need to know how it's coded. The length of stay in hospital after operation is coded in days, so that's not so difficult. Another data set that we'll be looking at in this part of the course is the RCT data set. It has some variables, some of these we looked at already, the aerobic capacity and the 6-minute walking distance, but it also has some items from a questionnaire called the Hospital Anxiety and Depression Scale, and it has some scores generated from these. So you can list the variables in the creation order, and you can also list them in alphabetic order. Sometimes it's useful to refer to many variables in one time. So I could refer to the 14 questionnaire items like this. Instead of writing all 14 variable names, I can write them like this because they have similar names. I could also refer to the SAS order. So if I write time and then slash time and then 2 hyphens and then V3, well, that is actually the variable time, the variable 6-minute walking distance, the variable V1, V2, and V3. I can refer to all character variables, or I can refer to all numeric variables. And finally, if I want to, I can refer to this called all, and that is simply all the variables in the data set. So I can open up SAS, I can use a libname statement. When I have the libname statement, I can double click on the library reference here, and in here I can look at the RCT dataset. It's located here. If I double click, it's opened up in view table, and we can see now if I want to make a dataset that contains only on the hospital anxiety and depression scale items, well, they are here, and then they are all the way down here, and then at the end I also have the grouping. So if I now want to do a study where I only look at the two groups, and I only look at if they have the same hospital anxiety and depression scale scores, well, then I can simply specify it like this. I want to make a new data set. I want to put in all of these values, and then I want to drop the variables V1, VO2 time and 6 minute walking distance. And if I do this, then I can create a new data set. I will submit it, look at the log file and see that it has 18 variables. If I go over here, go up and click on the work library and look at the heads that I just created, this one, I can see that it has exactly this. This is not a very helpful data example because I don't know the time, so I don't know if for these two measurements for person number 100, I don't know if it's baseline or follow-up measurement, so it's not very useful to do it like this, but it illustrates how we can use this. Here I can then look at the tables for all 14 items from the Hospital Anxiety and Depression Scale. It looks like this. Would it also work if I do like this? Well, it will take all the values that are all the variables that are created from the time this was created until this the time this was created, and because they are in that order in the data set, and we can see it here, this is the creation order, that would also work and it will give me the same output. So this statement and this statement is exactly the same in this situation because they have been created in this order. It's very useful to attach labels to variables. People who know the questionnaire well may know that the even numbers are anxiety, and sorry, that the uneven numbers are anxiety and that the even numbers are depression. And they may also know what that question 5 deals with worrying thoughts, that question 11 deals with feeling restless, and so on. But for the rest of us who do not know this, adding a label can then make it easy. So labels are a way to add information at the variable level, telling everybody what is the content of this variable. Formats do the same, but they do it not on the variable, but on the values of the variable. So a format is something that I can use to create a more informative table when I print something out. So if I printed one of the health questions out, I could have format attached to it saying if you score 1, what is the response you have given to the item, if you score 2, what's the response you have given to the item, and so on. So I go back to SAS, and then the code I copied from the homepage has this shortcoming that it uses something else, so I will just do this. So for the first 5 items, I now add a label, then I can look at a table, and now here I only keep these 7 anxiety items. I can copy this and put it in here, or as you recall, actually if I want a table of all of them, I can just write underscore all underscore. If I submit all of this, I get an error still because here I am still specifying the wrong variable names. So here I need to specify V, and let's keep only 5. V9. So now I keep only 5 items, and down here I specify tables all, and this should give me a table for all the items that are in the dataset, and there should be 5 items in that dataset. I submit all of this, and here I have my 5 tables, and you can see that for the first 3 I have this feel tense or wound up, get a frightened feeling, have worrying thoughts. So we know when we look at this what's the question that the patients in this study responded to, but we don't know what the response 1 means, we don't know what the response 2 means, and we don't know what the response 3 means. So we could put even more information in here, and this can be done using formats. So formats are something that SAS already has. There are numerical formats and there are many date formats and so on, but of course format saying 1 means male and 2 means female does not exist automatically. So this means in order to do this, I have to create a format like that. So I can create a format using the proc format statement. I specify value, I specify the name of the format, and then I say whenever there's a 1, write male, whenever there's a 2, write female. Let us try this out. And let me copy this and then go back to. Now I paste this in here and I now create a format. So to begin with, I just highlight this and I click on the running man and the log file says the format has been output. If I go to my Explorer window, I can see that in the work library there is a folder like this called formats. If I click on it, I can see that 6FMT exists in here. So the format I created has been recognized by SAS and it's been put in here. If I double click on it, I get this output that I can see that from 1 to 1 the label is male, from 2 to 2 the label is female. Now I can use this to look at a table where I add the format to the variable 6 in R. This gives me this output so that this table is now more informative than it was before. The Tanner score still looks like before. So I could add information in the same way. 1 means before puberty, 2 means beginning of puberty, 3 means middle of puberty, 4 end of puberty, and 5 after puberty. But I will instead illustrate that formats are something that live a life of their own. So here I use this format statement to take a variable and then take a format. I have to put a dot in here so SAS recognizes that it's a format, and then when I do this, the format is applied to the variable. But actually I could make a mistake here and write Tanner and then add the 6 format to Tanner. Take a minute to think about what will happen. Will it give me a mistake? Will it print the same thing as before? Or what will happen? Well, let's have a look. If I run it now, 6 in R is now 1 and 2 again, but up here 1 everywhere where there was the value 1 we write male, everywhere where there was the value 2 we write female. Notice also that this format has been created, but nothing in the code here where it was created says anything about this format being attached to a specific data set. In fact, I could take this code that talks about a completely different data set and then I could add a format statement down here. And I could say that for the variable v1 and the variable v3, I want this 6FMT format attached. Remember that I have to add a dot, so SAS recognizes this as a format. Again, this is meaningless, but it illustrates that a format can be applied anywhere, and all a format does is saying, well, a 1 that means male and a 2 that means female. So formats always contain a dot. Not when they're created, but whenever they're used, there's always a dot. I can create a format and I can attach it. So the format has nothing to do with any specific data set, but I can make a new data set where the format is permanently attached. So up here I had a procfrec statement, and then I use the format statement here. Down here, I have the format statement in my data set, and that means I create a new data set where the format is permanently attached to this variable. Then when I restart SAS, the format has disappeared, and so it's important to save your proc format code. But it's important to save all of your code, so that's not so different from what we know. Once I have generated many formats, I could click on them as you saw in SAS, but I can also run this code and it lists all the format that exists. Here's a more advanced example where I specify that everybody who is between 0 and 1 gets this label, everybody who is between 2 and 4 gets this label, and so on. This can be used, and then it actually changes. Here is a table of the original variable, and here is a table of the variable with a format attached. So actually doing this changes the way the output looks. Importantly, it does not change the underlying data. Let me copy this and then jump back to SAS. And let me illustrate that actually I could put something else in here. I could write young, I could write middle, and I could write oldest. Then if I submit all of this, I get this table attached to it. And if we want to keep on making strange tables that make no sense, well, I could just try out the table that I made for the Tanner variable, and then I could add this age group format to the Tanner variable, and then I get 1 and 2 is 0 and 1 is young, 2, 3 and 4 are middle, and the last group is oldest. So formats are very useful, but of course you have to be careful when you use them. If you use a wrong format, you get a wrong result. Here's an example of how you can save your formats for later. I specify this. This creates the format and saves it in the SAS user library. Then I can attach it permanently, and I can use this options FMT search, format search, to make SAS always look in the SAS user library for a format.